Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Ipshita Ghosh, your faculty for endodontics. We'll have some discussion on some important MCQs. Here goes the first one. Discoloration of tooth under big amalgam restoration can be prevented by option A using cavity varnish, option B using correct alloy ratio, alloy mercury ratio, option C using zinc phosphate cement base, option D washing the prepared cavity with sodium hypochlorite. So let me show you some picture. See, in what they are doing, they are putting cavity varnish in this. So what does varnish do? Varnish used to leave thin layer. Varnish used to leave thin layer inside the cavity. So thus it prevents any leakage of any restorative material given over this. Okay. So I think this prevents the discoloration of the tooth under big amalgam restoration. So if we see the other options, correct alloy mercury ratio, no, we always have to use correct alloy mercury ratio, but that doesn't change the color option. Then using zinc phosphate cement base, that doesn't prevent any leakage. Then washing the prepared cavity with sodium hypochlorite, it will change the chemical structure, not related to any prevention of color transfer. So what is the answer? Using cavity varnish. So discoloration of the tooth under big amalgam restoration can be prevented by using cavity varnish. Here goes the second one. The intercuspal width of an ideal class 1 cavity. They are asking for the occlusal one. Preparation for amalgam should be half, 1/3, 1/4 or 3/4. Which one? See, this diagram is showing the buccolingual width. Sorry, should be straight buccolingual width here, and this is the cusp tip. So this is the distance, intercuspal distance. So they are asking the intercuspal width of an ideal class 1 cavity preparation for amalgam should be, answer should be 1/4. You should know this answer. There's nothing to explain. Yes, there are some reasons for this, because of the strength, to maintain the strength of the restoration as well as the structure of the tooth, anatomy of the tooth, it should be 1/4. Okay. So suppose this is the intercuspal distance and this is the total buccolingual width. It should be, if we divide in fourth part, then it should be 1/4. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. It should be 1/4 to maintain the integrity of the tooth structure as well as the restorative material. The next question, the amalgam restoration should be burnished after 2 to 3 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, 1 hour or 24 hours. Okay, the option after 2 to 3 minutes, it's very less time, because we should give certain time for the setting reaction to be started. 10 to 15 minutes CS, we can burnish this after 10 to 15 minutes. 1 hour is the amalgam will be very hard. It will be very hard, and after 24 hours almost all the setting reaction will be completed, almost, not all the setting reaction. So it will be again very very hard, and after 2 to 3 minutes it will be soft. So answer is 10 to 15 minutes. Okay. So you should use some logic also sometimes. It's not that you will remember the answer, all the answer, all the numbers, all the timing, all the static reaction. Sometimes you have to use your logic. Okay. So next question, which is the weakest phase of the set amalgam? See, here is the setting reaction. You should know the setting reaction. Okay. When I will teach you about the amalgam, silver amalgam setting reaction, then I'll go to details. But for now, you just remember, gamma 2 phase is the weakest phase. Gamma 2 phase is the weakest phase, because this is the gamma 2 phase, stainless mercury 7 to 8. Okay, this have a very weak bond strength, so it used to dissolve. Okay, so this gamma 2 phase is the weakest phase. So what is the weakest phase of the set amalgam? Always remember, it's gamma 2. Now next question, delayed expansion of amalgam starts. Here also you have to use your general knowledge, or you should use some of your intelligence. But how? See the options, then you will understand. Option A, after 2 years. Option B, after 24 hours. Option C, after 3 to 5 months. Option D, after 3 to 5 days. Say after 2 years, there is no hope for expansion. So almost all the radiation or everything completed. Okay. So after 2 years, we cannot take the answer. It's very, if we use, as I have told in the beginning of this question, you should use your intelligence. So after 2 years, we won't take. After 24 hours, there are some certain chemical reaction will still go on. So delayed expansion will not be there. After 3 to 5 months is also very long time. So we cannot expect delayed expansion. What is the answer? Answer is after 3 to 5 days. So delayed expansion of amalgam is after 3 to 5 days. Okay, the next question. The number of line angles in class 2 amalgam cavity are, option is 6, then 12, 11, 7. So let me tell you some basic. Here I am drawing one cube to make you understand the line angles and the point angles. My cube is not perfect. Anyways, I hope you will draw a perfect cube. Okay. So, where all the line angles meet, this is known as point angle. These are the point angles. See? And where all the lines meet, this is the line angle. Suppose this line and this line is meeting here. So this is the line angle. Okay. And these three parts are meeting here. So this is the point angle. Point and the line. So number of line angles in class 2 amalgam cavity, sir. See, we should have the clear concept about the line angles and point angles. But it's not always easy to count and tell the numbers of the cavity lines. So it's better if you can memorize. Sometimes you have to memorize also. So here I am giving you one diagram. If you can remember this, it will be easier for you. So here is the description of line angles and point angles in class 2 cavity. See, here in case of class 1, line angle number is 8, point angle 4. Class 2, line angle 11, point angle 6. MOD cavity, line angle 14, point angle 8. In class 3 cavity, line angle 6, point angle 3. Class 5 cavity, line angle 11, point angle 6. Then in class 5 cavity, line angles 8, point angle 4. As I said, it's always, it's very difficult during your exam, you might be stressed or something like that. So it's very difficult to count the line angles and then give the answer. It is very time taking. So better sometimes you should prepare some chart and remember. So what is the answer? Answer is C. That is class 2 cavity has line angles of number 11. Okay. So it's a very clear cut answer. Next one, the liquid system of glass ionomer restorative material is essentially, see, for this glass ionomer cement, to remember, you should know the composition of the glass ionomer. So you have no other option, you have to remember this. So you have to remember the powder part and the liquid part. In powder we have silicon dioxide 29%. Then we have aluminium oxide 16%. Then we have calcium fluoride 34%. Then we have aluminium fluoride 5%. Then we have sodium aluminium fluoride 5%. Then we have aluminium phosphate 9.9% and some traces. Okay, this is the powder, and in the liquid we have polyacrylic acid, etaconic acid, then we have maleic acid, tricarbocation सिलिक एसिड, एसिड, देन वी हैव टार्टरिक एसिड एंड वाटर. सो व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? द लिक्विड सिस्टम ऑफ ग्लास एनमा रेस्टोरेटिव मेटेरियल इज एसेंशियली, आंसर इज पॉलीएक्रिलिक इटाकोनिक एसिड. दिस इज द पॉलीएक्रिलिक एसिड एंड दिस इज इटाकोनिक एसिड. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस कॉम्पोजिशन. यू देर इज नो अदर ऑप्शन, देर इज नथिंग टू एक्सप्लेन. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ ग्लास एनमा सीमेंट थ्रू आउट योर लाइफ टाइम. In this, just to have some revision, I'll tell you the classification. This is also a very important chart. Type 1 for luting, type 2 for restorative, type 3 for fast setting liner or base, type 4 for peat and fissure sealant, type 5 for luting for orthodontic purpose, type 6 for core buildup material, type 7 for high fluoride releasing command set GIC, type 8 for GIC for atraumatic restoration, and type 9 for geriatric and pediatric GIC. Okay, so you got the answer. Answer is polyacrylic itaconic acid. Coming to the next one, miracle mix, the first way, metal modified glass enema cement, type of proportioning of dental amalgam alloy and mercury, and superior mixture of filler and resin in composite restorative. Then mixture of superoxal, hypochloric acid and ether used for bleaching teeth. Let me tell you the answer is metal modified glass or enema cement. So let's have some little bit discussion on miracle mix. It was actually introduced in the year 1980 and it was given in the ratio of 7:1. Here 7 is the silver amalgam and GIC type 2 is used in one part. Okay, so the silver amalgam is 7 part, amalgam is 7 part, and type 2 GIC is 1 part, and the ratio is 7:1. In this ratio it was named as miracle mix, but then it was very popular few years back, but then after studying, after going through so much of extensive research and all, they have come to conclusion that miracle mix have no it's not that much better than this normal glass enema cement. Even if you mix silver amalgam and GIC, there is not much of change in the strength, but then only the color will be blackish. And then after some years, the popularity of this miracle mix has gone down. Still, you have to, for theoretical purpose, you have to remember this miracle mix. So the powder is glass and the silver, and particle size of silver is 3 to 4 micrometer, and liquid is malic acid 37% and tartaric acid 9%. Okay, so what is the answer? Answer of the miracle mix is option A, metal modified glass enema cement. Why metal modified? Because silver is added with glass enema. Then comes the next question, an EBS cement, the first way, modified calcium hydroxide cement, resin modified glass enema cement, modified zinc oxide eugenol cement, and option D, non-eugenol zinc oxide cement. What is EBA? EBA is ethoxy benzoic acid. Okay, ethoxy benzoic acid. It's actually modified zinc oxide eugenol cement. So your answer is, modified zinc oxide eugenol cement. The type of crown indicated where both the sticks and strength are required is option A, dicot crown, option B, porcelain feldspathic crown, option C, porcelain fused to metal crown, option D, bonded aluminium crown. Okay, let me show you one picture. See, there are different types of crown we are showing in this picture. See, this is the metal crown, this is the stainless steel crown, this is porcelain fused to metal crown, and this is all ceramic dental crowns, and this is all resin crown. Okay, do you think this is aesthetically very much acceptable? I don't think so, because I don't want my tooth to be silver or golden. I want my teeth to be natural like. So this is not aesthetically accepted. Then comes the stainless steel crown. Here also aesthetically it's not good. So this is not accepted if you think the aesthetic point of view. See, the question you have to see, aesthetic and strength, both are important. So what we'll see here in this two, these two are extremely aesthetic. These two are extremely aesthetic. But what about their strength? This is porcelain fused to metal. As we all know, porcelain is a bit brittle. So to make this crown more stable, what we give, we put metal inside and then over this porcelain. This is porcelain part and this is the metal part. Okay, thus it become the strongest one. So this is the strongest one, porcelain fused to metal. So if we think about the aesthetic and the strength part, what is the answer? What is the type of crown indicated? The answer is porcelain fused to metal.